something Wellington has a lot of. Horses, a beautiful animal that leaves behind a whole lot of waste. Waste that doesn't always get handled properly.
What we hear on a regular basis, on a yearly type basis, is the illegal dumping, where it's going into vacant properties and it's not being composted or it's not being spread or properly used.
It's a problem that can be harmful to your health.
As it's decomposing, it ends up in our groundwater. Eventually it filters down through and gets into our drinking water supplies.
Oh, mercy, mercy. All things ain't what they used to be. Lost my radiation underground and in the sky. Animals and birds who live nearby us now.
Along with the economic boom that comes from Palm Beach County's annual horse season is a messy problem that poses a smelly nuisance to residents. The polo and equestrian competitions generate about 180,000 tons of horse manure a year, creating a disposal problem that is getting tougher to solve, especially for those who pick up the manure.
You do 5-10 loads a week, it was no problem. But when you start stepping up to 50, 100 loads a week, it becomes a problem. Where am I going to get rid of it? How am I going to get rid of it? And that's where the farmers have all helped out, especially the sugarcane farmers. Now they take it from me, but not just me, but from everybody else in Wellington too. All my haulers, all the local competitors, everybody that wants to bring it to them, and it's free.
Although the sugar farmers take most of the manure, there is a worry that the manure is a pollution threat to the Everglades. Another solution would be building a recycling plant.
One plant recycles it into recycled wood shavings. Clean them, bleach them, rebag them, and sell them back to the customers. Obviously get the manure out of it, get it clean and perfect, sterilized, and then rebag it. And then it makes fire logs. Between local businesses and like U.S. Sugar and me, we're trying to figure out ways to do it, but it's expensive, $10 million for one plant, so.
For the Sun Sentinel, I'm Maria Lorenzino.
Raising a stink over a growing problem. Residents in the acreage say the stench of horse manure brought into their community by the truckload has become unbearable. News Channel 5's Dan Corcoran is live in Loxahatchee tonight with our story. Dan.
And some residents tell us that that smell of all that manure plus the flies that come along with it, even fear of contamination of the water supply, is asking them to ask Palm Beach County to step in. Kim Bolser Alman loves taking care of her horses and doesn't mind dealing with what they leave behind. Tonight, we're talking about, well,
poop.
But not just a little bit of horse manure.
It's fresh, steaming from the horse farms.
Mounds and mounds of it. Truckloads that some residents here say is smelling up and taking over this Loxahatchee neighborhood.
It doesn't dissipate because the quantity of it is so much.
Much of the manure is being hauled in from Wellington's equestrian facilities and dumped on residential properties where the owner gives the okay.
Dumped, spread, and let to rot.
Richard Ochter is a professional landscaper and knows that composted horse manure can be beneficial and should continue to be allowed here.
They can continually dump it and dump it and dump it.
Ochter and some of his neighbors, though, have had enough, taking their concerns now to the Palm Beach County Board of Commissioners. Today, commissioners pushed forward plans for new disposal rules that would put limits on dumping livestock waste on land where it wasn't generated. These residents, dealing with a
poop
problem, say the new restrictions sound and smell good.
As soon as you walk outside, clearly then it hits you.
And they say that needs to change. Now, some farming groups say these proposed measures just go too far and that the county should worry more about enforcing existing agriculture pollution regulations, not creating new rules at this point. County commissioners will tackle this interesting topic once again next month. Reporting live in Loxahatchee tonight, I'm Dan Corcoran, WPTV News Channel 5.
Okay.
So we're back speaking here with FAU professor and scientist Dr. Bill Lauda.
Things like one big thing, I've been working with Palm Beach County Commissioner Melissa McKinley and her assistant Johnny Easton on the equestrian waste from the Wellington. That's a huge industry, multi-million dollars being pumped into Palm Beach County through that industry. It's a beautiful industry. But the waste, to handle it properly, should be recycled. There's some recycling companies out there that do a fantastic job. The water they use is completely recycled in-house, and the shavings, the wood shavings, are cleaned up, sterilized, and put and resold to be used again. The other problem with horse manure, besides the phosphorus that I see, is extremely extractable for phosphorus. The horse manure also has a lot of therapeutic drugs that the horses get, and that also leaches out. So take a look at yourself, then make a change. U.S. Sugar has taken a lot of this waste and has put it on their on the LA Canal on different places there. They're trying to do soil remediation by spreading the manure and the what I call barn bottoms, the shavings, urine and manure soaked shavings onto these fields. With the very heavy rains we've had, it would not surprise me at all if that's coming down and the soil is peat soil on top of carbonate, and all of these are extremely porous. The water just goes right through them, so anything you get comes out.
Yeah. So just for those of you just joining in, we're speaking with FAU scientist Dr. Bill Lauda. My name's Josh. We're also here with our investigative producer, Nils, who's now holding the phone.